Ngorongoro Crater in Ngorongoro Conservation Area, Tanzania. The jewel in Ngorongoro's crown is a deep, volcanic crater, the largest unflooded and unbroken caldera in the world. About 20 kilometers across, 600 meters deep and 300 square kilometers in area, the Ngorongoro Crater is a breathtaking natural wonder. The main feature of the Ngorongoro Conservation Authority is the Ngorongoro Crater, the world's largest inactive, intact and unfilled volcanic caldera. The crater, which formed when a large volcano exploded and collapsed on itself 2 to 3 million years ago. Estimates of the height of the original volcano range from 4,500 to 5,800 meters high. The crater floor is 1,800 meters above sea level. The crater was voted by Seven Natural Wonders as one of the Seven Natural Wonders of Africa in Arusha, Tanzania in February 2013. The Ngorongoro volcano was active from about 2.45 to 2 million years ago. The volcanic eruptions like that of Ngorongoro, which resulted in the formation of Ngorongoro Crater in Tanzania, were very common. Similar collapses occurred in the case of Olmedie and Nkpakai, but they were much smaller in magnitude and impact. Out of the two recent volcanoes to the northeast of the Nkpakai caldera, Kermasi and Oliver Doi Inyolingai is still active and had major eruptions in 2007 and 2008. Smaller ash eruptions and lava flows continued to slowly fill the current crater. Its name is Maasai language for Mountain of God. The Munk stream drains Olmedie Crater to the north, and is the main water source draining into the seasonal salt lake in the center of the crater. This lake is known by two names, Makata's the Maasai called it, meaning salt, and Magadi. The Lerai stream drains the humid forests to the south of the crater, and it feeds the Lerai forest on the crater floor. When there is enough rain, the Lerai drains into Lake Magadi as well. Extraction of water by lodges in Ngorongoro Conservation Area headquarters reduces the amount of water entering Lerai by around 25%. The other major water source in the crater is the Ngoitikatok Spring, near the eastern crater wall. There is a picnic site here open to tourists and a huge swamp fed by the spring, and the area is inhabited by hippopotamus, elephants, lions and many others. Many other small springs can be found around the crater's floor, and these are important water supplies for the animals and local Maasai, especially during times of drought. Maasai were previously permitted to graze their cattle within the crater, but as of 2015 were restricted from doing so. Ngorongoro Conservation Area. The Ngorongoro Conservation Area spans vast expanses of highland plains, savanna, savanna woodlands and forests. Established in 1959 as a multiple land use area, with wildlife coexisting with semi-nomadic Maasai pastoralists practicing traditional livestock grazing, it includes the spectacular Ngorongoro Crater, the world's largest caldera. The property has global importance for biodiversity conservation due to the presence of globally threatened species, the density of wildlife inhabiting the area, and the annual migration of wildebeest, zebra, gazelles and other animals into the northern plains. Extensive archaeological research has also yielded a long sequence of evidence of human evolution and human environment dynamics, including early hominid footprints dating back 3.6 million years. The Ngorongoro Conservation Area spans vast expanses of highland plains, savanna, savanna woodlands and forests, from the plains of the Serengeti National Park in the northwest, to the eastern arm of the Great Rift Valley. The area was established in 1959 as a multiple land use area, with wildlife coexisting with semi-nomadic Maasai pastoralists practicing traditional livestock grazing. It includes the spectacular Ngorongoro Crater, the world's largest caldera, and the Olduvai Gorge, a 14 kilometers long deep ravine. The property has global importance for biodiversity conservation in view of the presence of globally threatened species such as the black rhino. The density of wildlife inhabiting the Ngorongoro Crater and surrounding areas throughout the year, and the annual migration of wildebeest, zebra, Thompson's and Grant's gazelles and other ungulates into the northern plains. The area has been subject to extensive archaeological research for over 80 years and has yielded a long sequence of evidence of human evolution and human environment dynamics, collectively extending over a span of almost 4 million years to the early modern era. This evidence includes fossilized footprints and lateri, associated with the development of human bipedalism, a sequence of diverse, evolving hominin species within Old Uvai Gorge, which range from Australopiths such as Zinchanthropus boyi to the Homo lineage that includes Homo habilis, Homo erectus and Homo sapiens, an early form of Homo sapiens at Lake Njutu, and, in the Ngorongoro crater, remains that document the development of stone technology and the transition to the use of iron. The overall landscape of the area is seen to have the potential to reveal much more evidence concerning the rise of anatomically modern humans, modern behavior and human ecology. The property was inscribed under natural criteria in 1979 and under cultural criterion in 2010. Thus, the statement of integrity reflects integrity for natural values at the date of inscription of 1979, and for the cultural value in 2010. In relation to natural values, the grasslands and woodlands of the property support very large animal populations, largely undisturbed by cultivation at the time of inscription. The wide-ranging landscapes of the property were not impacted by development or permanent agriculture at the time of inscription. The integrity of the property is also enhanced by being part of Serengeti, Marna ecosystem. The property adjoins Serengeti National Park, which is also included on the World Heritage List as a natural property. Connectivity within and between these properties and adjoining landscapes, through functioning wildlife corridors, is essential to protect the integrity of animal migrations. No hunting is permitted in Ngorongoro Conservation Area, but poaching of wildlife is a continuing threat, requiring effective patrolling and enforcement capacity. Invasive species are a source of ongoing concern, requiring continued monitoring and effective action if detected. Tourism pressure is also of concern, including in relation to the potential impacts from increased visitation, new infrastructure, traffic, waste management, and disturbance to wildlife and the potential for introduction of invasive species. The property provides grazing land for semi-nomadic Maasai pastoralists. At the time of inscription, an estimated 20,000 Maasai were living in the property, with some 275,000 head of livestock, which was considered within the capacity of the reserve. No permanent agriculture is officially allowed in the property. Further growth of the Maasai population and the number of cattle should remain within the capacity of the property, and increasing sedentarization, local overgrazing and agricultural encroachment are threats to both the natural and cultural values of the property. There were no inhabitants in Ngorongoro and in Pakai Craters or the forest at the time of inscription in 1979. The property encompasses not only the known archaeological remains but also areas of high archaeoanthropological potential where related finds might be made. However, the integrity of specific paleoarchaeological attributes and the overall sensitive landscape are to an extent under threat and thus vulnerable due to the lack of enforcement of protection arrangements related to grazing regimes, and from proposed access and tourist-related developments at Lederli and Old Uvai Gorge. Like us and join us at Xtreme Collections for more fun and knowledge.